Hi learners, welcome. In this video, I'm going to explain third type of chemical reaction. It's related to stoichiometry, that is decomposition reaction. So first, let me define what is decomposition reaction. Decomposition reaction means when a single compound is undergoing dissociation into two or more products, simple products, then we call it as a decomposition reaction. Example, if I take a compound AB, it may undergo dissociation into A plus B. Then we call it as a decomposition reaction. Okay, so one compound is undergoing dissociation into two different compounds. Similarly, if I take three compound mixture like A, B, C, then they can form more than two also, A plus B plus C. So such type of reactions are said to be decomposition reactions. Let's see how many types of decomposition reactions we have. What are the examples for each type? Broadly, we can classify decomposition reactions into three types. They are thermal decomposition reactions, thermal decomposition, electrical decomposition reactions, and photo decomposition reactions. These are the three types of decomposition reactions. Let's start with thermal. Thermal means what? We have to heat. We have to heat the reaction. Means in order to undergo dissociation of a particular compound, we have to heat that compound. Then it will undergo dissociation into different simple compounds or elements. Example, I can give you here calcium carbonate, which is a solid. When you heat this one, it undergo dissociation into two simple compounds, calcium oxide, which is a solid, and carbon dioxide. Calcium oxide and carbon dioxide, again, is a gas. See here, a single compound, when we heat thermally, it is undergoing dissociation into two simple compounds, calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So it's an example for decomposition. And moreover, here we are heating this reaction to dissociate calcium carbonate. So it comes under thermal decomposition reaction. This is the first example. Similarly, I can take one more example, that is potassium chlorate. You take potassium chlorate, which is a solid. When you heat this one, so thermal decomposition means you have to heat this compound, that means reactant. Then it undergoing dissociation into potassium chloride as well as it releases oxygen gas. If I want to balance this reaction, how many moles of oxygen will be released here? 3 moles. So 2 moles of this, 2 moles of this. This is a balanced reaction. Similarly, one more example I am going to give for thermal decomposition, that is ferric hydroxide. FeOH three times. When you heat this one, it undergo dissociation into ferric oxide by leaving water. Okay, ferric oxide is a solid and this is a liquid. This is an aqueous. Okay, if you want to balance this reaction, 2 moles of this and 3 moles of H2O. So these are the few examples for thermal decomposition. In any case, you see only single compound is involving in this reaction and it is undergoing dissociation into more than one products. Now let's see what is an electrical decomposition. So we can use even electricity. The other name for this is electrolysis. We call it as electrolysis. So what we have to do, we have to place electrodes in the solution. Which one you want to dissociate in that solution, you have to place the electrodes and you have to pass the electricity. So here electricity is playing important role to dissociate that compound. Example, electrolysis of water. 2 moles of water if I take and if I do electrolysis, means if I apply an electric current through this solution, it undergo dissociation into H2 plus O2. One of the example, Similarly, one more example I will give you, that is electrolysis of sodium chloride, NaCl. When NaCl undergoes electrolysis, means you supply electric current through this, take sodium chloride solution and pass electricity through this. Then what happens? It undergoes dissociation into sodium metal and releases chlorine gas. Okay, 2 moles of this, 2 moles of this. It's a balanced reaction. And similarly, let's see the example for third one, that is photo decomposition. I will take here example for photo decomposition. Third type. So here what we will do, we simply place that reaction in sunlight. You have to take the reactants and you have to expose those reactants, means only one reactant will be there, to the sunlight. So sunlight plays important role to decompose that compound. Example, you take silver chloride and place it in sunlight. You can find after some time silver will be separated from this and it will release chlorine gas. 2 moles of this. Okay. Similarly, if I take hydrogen peroxide, one more example, hydrogen peroxide, which is a liquid, and when it is exposed to sunlight, it undergoes decomposition into water as well as releases oxygen, which is a gas. It's a balanced reaction. I wrote a balanced reaction. So in this way, decomposition of a simple compound, a single compound into simple products is called dissociation reaction, and it may, the dissociation of the any reactant may take place in three ways. They may take place through thermally or through electrically or through photolytically. So itself generally it won't undergo decomposition. We have to heat it, or we need to supply some electricity to the solution, or you have to use some sunlight to decompose it. So these are the ways to decompose a compound into simple products. That's all about decomposition reaction. Thank you for watching.